the pilot who stole a secret Soviet fighter jet. This is a story of a former Soviet pilot who defected to the West during the Cold War while flying his MiG-25 jet fighter and landed in Japan. George W. Bush, the director of Central Intelligence at the time, called the opportunity to examine the plane up close, an intelligence bonanza for the West. Let us dive into the secrets he disclosed and the impact of his flight on world affairs. We're talking about none other than Viktor Belenko, who was a former Soviet Top Gun pilot. He was sick and tired of a communist regime and wanted to leave from his country, but he didn't choose to defect by wandering through an embassy or by entering other lands through the sea route. He chooses to steal the most secretive aircraft the Soviet Union has ever built. His name is famous, as he successfully defected by flying his MiG-25 Foxbat jet fighter to Hakodate, Japan. Viktor Belenko was a Soviet citizen. He was born when World War II was just ending, in a traditional family at Nalchik, Russian Soviet Federative Socialist Republic. When he grew up, he entered military service and became a fighter pilot with the 513th Fighter Regiment, 11th Air Army. Belenko's father was facing a divorce. He was getting upset and disillusioned. He started to question the very nature of Soviet society and wondered whether America was as evil as the communist regime suggested. He had questions in his mind. He might know about the US government's policy that they awarded large cash prizes to defecting pilots who belonged to communist countries. Belenko found that the huge new fighter he was training in those days could be helpful to escape. He was based at the Chuguyevka Air Base in Primorsky Krai, near the eastern city of Vladivostok. About 400 miles, 644 kilometers away, was Japan. The new MiG could fly fast and high, but it has two giant gas-guzzling engines that couldn't fly very far to reach Belenko's dreamland US air base. He wanted to go to the US, but it was impossible for him. Now here comes the turning point, which highlighted the name of Viktor Belenko. The fighter jet in which Viktor Belenko defected was a mysterious threat in the eyes of US defense chiefs. They saw him only through the blurred photos taken from space and blips on radar screens above the Mediterranean in the early 1970s. They gave it a code, Foxbat. Viktor Belenko worked on his mission. He calculated facts and figures. Belenko found that to hide from the Soviet and Japanese military radar, he had to fly at a low height, about 100 feet above the sea. He memorized the map and invented a route from where he should escape. Thus, the day came. On the 6th of September 1976, the 29-year-old Flight Lieutenant Viktor Ivanovich Belenko of the Soviet Air Defense Forces flew off with fellow pilots on a training mission. The MiGs were not armed. His MiG had a tank full of fuel. He broke the formation, flew over the waves at 100 feet. When his jet was far enough from the Japanese airbase, he flew about 20,000 feet. To come in the eyes of Japanese radar. The Japanese tried to hail, but the frequencies were mistakenly changed by Belenko. When this happened, the Japanese fighters went to attack this new and unidentified aircraft, but Belenko hid the jet in thick clouds. He was lucky that he disappeared from the Japanese radar. Belenko's destination was Chitose Air Base, but because of running fuel, he decided to land on the northern island of Hokkaido, Japan. His jet had gray Hulk sports and the red stars of the Soviet Union. He landed the jet on the runway of Hakodate. At first, he fired two warning shots from his pistol and then announced that he wanted to defect. The strange thing was not the defection. It was the jet which wondered everyone. Mikoyan Gurevich MiG-25. It was the most secretive aircraft the Soviet Union has ever built. This was the very first time that the Western experts team got a close look at the aircraft. The airport becomes a hive of Western intelligence. No one in the West had ever seen this jet before. For 2 days, they only saw it from the outside. After that, it revealed many secrets and surprises. Going back to the 1970s, spy satellites while stalking Soviet airfields caught a new type of aircraft being tested in secret. They were like enormous fighter planes. The West's militaries were focusing only on one particular feature that they sported very large wings. A plane that has large wings is easy to lift, weight distributed across the wings, and thus easy to turn. The US Air Force was worried about how fast it could go. This XB-70 bomber would have been able to fly at 3 times the speed of sound. They thought that the Soviet fighter could outturn anything in the US Air Force. But unfortunately, it was a case of military misinterpretation. The MiG-25 is about 64 feet long. It was a few feet shorter than a World War II-era Lancaster bomber. The airframe was this big only to accommodate the engines and the huge amount of fuel needed to power them. The MiG-25 could use up to 30,000 pounds of fuel. That heavy steel airframe was the reason the MiG-25 had such large wings, but it couldn't help it dogfight with US fighters, but simply to keep it in the air. The MiGs were designed to take off and accelerate to Mach 2.5 to approach targets by large ground-based radars. When they were within 50 miles, 80 kilometers, their onboard radars would be able to take over and they would fire their missiles, which in keeping with the MiG's enormous size, were some 20 feet long, 6 meters. After studying all facts, they found that the MiG-25 was not a very useful combat aircraft. It was also very expensive. But he helped the US to make the F-series, which is still in work. On the other hand, Belenko had brought him the MiG-25 Foxbat because he was expecting to assist American pilots in evaluating and testing the aircraft. The Japanese government at first only allowed the US to inspect the plane and do ground tests of the radar and engines. Later, the Japanese invited the Americans to examine the plane, and it was dismantled in Japan. The plane was moved by a US Air Force C-5 Galaxy cargo aircraft from Hakodate to Hayakuri Air Base. Experts evaluate that the plane was an interceptor, not a fighter bomber, which was a sign of relief to the Japanese Air Force. The Japanese government decided to return the aircraft in 30 crates. It bills the Soviet US $40,000 for crating services and airfield damage to Hakodate. The Soviets tried to negotiate a return with one of their own Antonov An-22 aircraft and attempted to organize a rigorous inspection of the crates, but Japan denied both demands and the Soviets, at last fulfilled the Japanese requirements. The MiG-25 was moved from Hayakuri Air Base to the port of Hitachi on 11th of November on a convoy of trailers. It was released in 30 crates aboard the Soviet cargo ship Tigonos on the 15th of November 1976. And reached about 3 days later in Vladivostok. A team of Soviet technicians had been allowed to view sub-assemblies at Hitachi, and they found that 20 parts were missing, one being the film of the flight to Hakodate. The Soviets charged Japan $10 million, but countries neither paid the bills. Viktor Belenko's defection caused a huge loss to the Soviet Union Air Force. He was granted asylum by US President Gerald Ford, and a trust fund was set up for him, which granted him a very comfortable living in later years. The US government interrogated and debriefed him for 5 months after his defection. They employed him as an American aerospace engineer and consultant for several years thereafter. After his defection, he co-wrote an autobiography in 1980, MiG Pilot, The Final Escape of Lieutenant Belenko, with Reader's Digest writer John Barron. While residing in the United States, Belenko married a music teacher from North Dakota, Coral. He had two sons, Tom and Paul. Afterward, he divorced. He also has a son from his first marriage whose name is Dmitry. Belenko has never divorced his Russian wife, whom he was married to for only 5 years. After the dissolution of the Soviet Union, he visited Moscow in 1995 on business terms. Belenko seldom appears in interviews, but in 2000, he gave a brief and informal bar interview. He posed for pictures and answered the queries. He said that he was happy in the United States. Belenko stated in the interview that Americans have tolerance regarding other people's opinion. In certain cultures, if you do not accept the mainstream, you would be booted out or might disappear. Here we have people, you know, who hug trees, and people who want to cut them down, and they live side by side. The Soviet Union many times spread false stories about Belenko, that he was being killed in a car accident. They spread that he had returned to Russia. Sometimes they said that he's being arrested and executed. But the truth is, he became a resident of the USA.